Hello, I'm Graham and I hope everyone's having a great day. Now, hopefully you can hear me over the wind noise. It's quite a windy day here in the north of England. The sun's coming up, but it's still quite cold and very windy. Now, today's video is actually a proof of concept, an idea of mine to have remote audio for the Panasonic Lumix FZ82, and in fact any other camera that doesn't have a microphone input. So normally when you're recording something like 30 feet away, as I am now, you couldn't use the internal microphones of the camera. In fact, we're recording this now on the Panasonic Lumix FZ80 or 82 in the UK, and that doesn't have a microphone input. So my idea of an acoustic coupler which takes the output from the portable recorder that I'm using to capture the audio separately, taking the output from that and then by using earbuds, use those as an acoustic coupler into the microphone inputs of the camera. You can see on screen now my sort of proof of concept idea. Now it would be ideal if I could actually 3D print something that held the microphones a little bit in closer proximity to the mic port, so I just had to file some aluminium and mount some earbuds into that to try and get a proof of concept idea, so hopefully it's going to work. Now for this test I'm using my Samsung Airline wireless system. It's not the best system out there in the marketplace. There is a little bit of noise behind the audio with the device. I'll switch over to my Sennheiser kit in a minute just to see if there's any difference. But the idea was to try and give you some idea of what you could achieve using my audio coupler device and using maybe a lapel microphone with a 20-foot lead if you wanted to get a little bit further away from the camera. So I'm going to switch over now to a lapel mic and a Saramonic mixer to give me a different input from the Samsung Airline, just to see if there's any difference in audio quality between the types of input device. Well, this second test is using a Saramonic mic mixer with a wired lapel microphone. Got about 15 foot of cable on here back to the camera. The output from the Saramonic mic mixer is going into the Olympus LS12 PCM recorder, and the output from that recorder is going to drive the earbuds which are in the acoustic coupler on top of the FZ80-82 camera. So get an idea of what a wired lapel system sounds like using the PCM recorder as the driving source for the earpieces which are then coupled into the camera. And we're going to switch over to the professional Sennheiser wireless system just to see if there's any difference in quality between that and the Samsung Airline. I'm expecting there will be. There should be less background noise and the microphone is a better quality than the airline system. So let's switch over to Sennheiser and have a look at how that performs. Well, for this test I'm using the Sennheiser, and it's the W100 series radio transmission system. So we've got a professional grade microphone and transmitter receiver system, using that to input into the Olympus LS12 recorder, and the output from that again is the acoustic coupler on top of the FZ82. So we're taking the output from that LS12 and acoustic coupling that into the mic inputs on the FZ82. So hopefully this is going to give you better audio quality from the system. We've got a much higher grade wireless system, so there shouldn't be that amount of background noise. With a fur shield over the microphone, that should have cut down on any wind noise as well. So hopefully the system is now working at its best advantage. Well, that's my proof of concept idea. I'm going to put some technical information about this device on my Photographic blog, and I'll put a link to that in the video description below if you wanted to try and emulate this, or if you've come up with any better ideas for connecting the microphones into the camera. I say, if I had 3D printing equipment, I should be able to make a device which would clip better to the microphone input ports on the FZ80-82 camera, or in fact on something like the G85 which doesn't have a mic input, so I'll be looking at that in my next project box. Well, that's it for the video. Hope you found that useful and give you some ideas for your own devices for connecting audio into cameras that don't have a microphone input. As usual, if you're a new viewer and you haven't clicked the subscribe button, please do so, and also the bell notification icon, and then you'll be notified when I upload new videos to my channel. Check out my Photographic blog, I'll put a link to that in video description below. You'll find lots more information on photography, about Panasonic Lumix cameras, systems cameras, and also Canon M50 series cameras. So, until the next video, thanks as usual for watching, please do take care, and I hope to see you all in the next one. Goodbye for now.